Hey guys, this is EckhartsLadder. Hello and welcome to another episode of Star Wars Galactic Versus, the series where we take two things from different universes, put them head to head, and try to predict which one would come out on top. Today we have a fun, but what might end up being short episode featuring two of my favorite monsters in science fiction. On one hand, we have Godzilla, of course, probably the most famous kaiju of all time, and on the other hand, we have the Zillo Beast from the Star Wars Clone Wars series, clearly inspired not only in name, but also in function by Godzilla. In this video, we're gonna put both of these monsters head-to-head and try to predict which one would win in a real-life scenario. Obviously, both of these monsters only exist in their fiction, so when I say in a real-world battle, I mean we're gonna look at the matchup holistically. In other words, all characteristics of both of these creatures will be considered in deciding which one is better. Before we get to the actual matchup, I am going to take a few minutes to talk about the characteristics, feats, and attributes of these two creatures individually. So, if you already are really familiar with both of them and you want to just go to the matchup, I'll put a timestamp on the screen. For everyone else, let's start with the Zillo Beast. Despite how cool of a creature is, the Zillo Beast only has two major appearances in Star Wars canon. That's in the 19th and 20th episodes of the Clone Wars television show. These episodes, which are quite fittingly called The Zillo Beast and The Zillo Beast Returns, are actually some of my favorite of the series. Basically, for 40 whole minutes, we have Palpatine scheming and being sneaky. We have a ton of cool action scenes, some including Yoda and R2-D2. We get some nice shots of Coruscant, and of course, we have the Chancellor saying, "I've got a bad feeling about this," which is kind of funny. The episode starts off with the Republic fighting the Separatists on the planet of Malastare, trying to get the Dug, who is the species of which Sebulba belongs to join the Republic and to fight against the Separatists. Because the Republic is losing the battle on the ground, they drop an electrical bomb. Now, this does successfully defeat the droid army, and that's really the last we see of the Separatists in the two episodes, but it also wakes up the Zillo Beast. The Zillo Beast proceeds to thrash through the planet. It's basically impervious to traditional weapons, including Anakin's lightsaber, and is only stopped through a combined effort of many stun tanks. Chancellor Palpatine learns about the Zillo Beast and its really strong scales, and thinks to himself that he could probably make some badass clone armor. So, with the Zillo Beast incapacitated because the Jedi, due to their moral code, refuse to kill it, they bring the creature to Coruscant. Unsurprisingly, after being locked up and studied on Coruscant, the Zillo Beast of course manages to escape, and again, it goes through the city, causing major havoc and almost killing the Chancellor, Anakin, Padme, and of course C-3PO and R2-D2. Thankfully for the Coruscanti and the Republic, a gas native to the planet Malastare, which is supposedly fatal to the beast, has been synthesized and is used to take him down once and for all, sadly killing the creature. That's basically where the episode ends. Palpatine tells one of the Republic's chief doctors to start working on cloning the beast's remains, but we haven't heard anything else about that in canon, at least up to this point. So, let's talk about the beast himself. The Zillo Beast was a legendary creature on Malastare. The Dug thought that they had exterminated the entire species, and when a new one showed up, they considered it a threat to their entire civilization. Interestingly, at the beginning of the second episode in the arc, the narrator calls the beast the most dangerous creature in the galaxy. Now, whether that's hyperbole or not, the Zillo Beast is still not to be messed with. Physically, obviously, the Zillo Beast is quite intimidating. He's 97 meters in height and weighs over 60,000 metric tons. Defensively, as I mentioned, the beast is quite durable. Anakin's lightsaber does not even scratch its scales. However, there is also some weakness here. The durability doesn't come from the creature's skin, it comes from its scales. This means that the beast has weaknesses where the scales don't cover its body, and we see on one occasion that the Republic actually exploits these weaknesses. While traditional weaponry didn't show any sign of slowing the beast down, when the Republic uses their stun tanks and aims at the exposed areas, they are able to incapacitate the creature, at least temporarily. The same can be said for the beast's romp through Coruscant. Although the Republic isn't able to stop him with any sort of light gunships or any ground-based weapons, they are able to take it down with the poisonous gases. So again, conventional weapons aren't really very effective, but specialized weapons can work. Offensively, the beast is quite gifted. Not only is it very large, but it's also quite fast and nimble. We see when in Coruscant that it's able to move through buildings very quickly. The beast has a large tail, which it can use to hit enemies, and also a third arm, which is quite unique. Obviously, a creature of the beast's size is quite strong, and we see that it picks up Republic tanks like they're nothing and tosses them. One question unanswered by both episodes relates to the intelligence of the Zillo Beast. We see that it's at least semi-sentient, but we're unable to establish whether it actually has full sentience. Arguably though, its sentience and its capacity for thought won't be super important in this battle because we're going to assume that it's enraged and really just interested in killing Godzilla. Before we look at whether it actually can do so, let's take a look at Godzilla himself, the king of the kaiju. Godzilla has been around for a very long time, and as such, there are dozens of different variations on the monster. Because I want to keep things topical and I want to use a version of Godzilla that I think most of you guys will be familiar with, we're going to use the one from the 2014 American movie. I would have liked to use Shin Godzilla just because his design is so cool, but I still haven't got around to watching the movie yet, and I just didn't have enough time to before making this video. The Godzilla in the 2014 movie, and really all Godzillas generally, is a force of nature. And I mean that both figuratively, but also according to some of the characters within the movie, in a literal sense as well. The Godzilla in this universe existed since at least 1954, at which point it survives a nuclear bomb which was supposed to kill it. Later, in 2014, after the appearance of two Mutos, which are basically two other monsters, Godzilla appears again, fights the two monsters, breaks some skyscrapers, and then returns to the sea. Godzilla is gigantic. He is 108 meters tall, 167 meters long, and almost 100,000 tons. As a note, this puts him decisively larger than the Zillo Beast. Godzilla, however, is built much differently than the Zillo Beast. He doesn't have a third arm, for example, and the two arms that he does have are quite short, and that's one vulnerability. However, he has spikes on his back, very sharp teeth, and claws, all of which can be used as a weapon. Godzilla is very, very durable. We see in the movie, although he only appears for 8 minutes, that he tanks shots from modern US weapons and doesn't even really notice them. In the 1950s, he also survived being attacked by what was presumably a direct hit by an atomic bomb. In the movie, he fights off two Mutos, both of which are quite large themselves, and although he does get exhausted towards the end of the movie and collapse, we see skyscrapers fall on him, we see the Mutos attack him directly, and he never shows any sign of actual physical damage. Godzilla also appears to be covered pretty much everywhere with armor-like scales, although he does have one weakness, the two gills on the sides of his neck. This allows him to swim underwater indefinitely, but he does seem to be sensitive to any attacks there. Still, this version of Godzilla is extraordinarily durable, and we don't really see anything faze him in the movie, although he does struggle to actually kill, as I mentioned, two Mutos who are working together to try to take him down. Besides for his obvious physical attributes, Godzilla has another offensive weapon, his atomic breath. Godzilla can basically use his atomic breath to release large amounts of energy. We see that this doesn't destroy his enemies like it did in some of his other iterations, but it does still knock them back, and later when he shoots down one of the Muto's throat, it's powerful enough to allow him to decapitate the monster. With that being said, I think that's a good summary of both of these creatures. Let's now put them head to head and try to predict which one would win. So I'm not gonna lie, when I first thought about this matchup, I thought that Godzilla would win this quite easily. I mean, he is noticeably larger than the Zillo Beast, he has his atomic breath, and he's just super, super durable. I will say that I do still think Godzilla will take this matchup. He's too strong and he is too durable. However, I think it's gonna be closer than I initially predicted. The Zillo Beast is exceptionally mobile, and we see during the Godzilla movie that he suffers when fighting creatures that have that mobility. Also, one of Godzilla's biggest weaknesses is his short arms. This makes grappling other monsters very, very difficult. I'm not sure if this was intentional, but the Zillo Beast is basically the opposite of that. Not only are his arms very long and very capable, but he's got three of them. Much like the kaiju did in the Godzilla movie, I can see the Zillo Beast using his speed and his long arms to basically get behind Godzilla and grapple him, trying to take him down that way. However, the Zillo Beast lacks quite sorely when compared to Godzilla in pure strength, and I think that will be the one game changer here. Although Godzilla does lack the finesse, he is very, very durable, and I just don't know what the Zillo Beast can do to actually harm him. I think the second Godzilla really gets a hold on him, he either just straight up breaks him over his knee, somehow cracks him open or breaks his arm off, or if he can't hurt him in a conventional means, he opens his mouth up and gets him with that atomic breath. I also think Godzilla and his claws and his spines will be able to take advantage of the weak points on the Zillo Beast's body. Godzilla is just too big and too strong, and the Zillo Beast, despite his long arms and his speed, doesn't have the real game changer he would need to actually defeat him. If Godzilla had been the one to escape on Coruscant, the Republic wouldn't have been able to waste time trying to do Jedi trickery. They would have just had to bomb the planet from orbit, because that's the kind of threat he is. So yeah, I give this one to Godzilla, and I think he wins probably 7.5 times out of 10. I do give that bit of chance if for the Zillo Beast to use his long arms and his exceptional speed, but I just don't think that that will be enough. That, however, is just my opinion. I would love to hear what you guys think. What did you think of this episode? Do you think I got it right? Did you love it? What do you want to see next time? Let me know all of that and anything else down in the comment section. Also, if you like this video, please give me a like and a subscription, and I'll bring more exciting, fun Star Wars content your way. Also, just a brief note, I do have my Q&A coming up. I'm most likely going to film it Saturday or Sunday, so expect it during this weekend. Anyways, thank you so much for watching, guys. As always, this has been EckhartsLadder. May the Force be with you. Thank you.